So there have been a few studies that have come out about the health of transgender female adults. So that's people who are born with a male sex, who have a female gender identity. And standard of care by the Endocrine Society guidelines and the World Professional Association for Transgender Health includes, for young people, blocking their puberty with a puberty blocker or gonadotropin-releasing hormone analog to prevent their body from having those male pubertal changes or male secondary sex characteristics. And then later in adolescence or in adulthood, if they come to you post-pubertal or in adulthood, treating with estradiol with androgen blocker or male hormone blocker. So I was very interested in what effects these medications have on people's overall health. There have been some studies of transgender females on estradiol that have shown that they have higher rates of strokes, heart attacks, and venous thromboembolism or blood clots, and also that they have changes in their body composition and perhaps some changes in their cholesterol panel or other markers of cardiometabolic health. So my study was a cross-sectional study, being a snapshot in time, looking at adolescent transgender females. Their average age was 16, who had been on estradiol for about a year, compared to age and BMI-matched control males and females. And our main outcomes were looking at changes in their body composition as well as their insulin sensitivity. And we found that there were several differences in markers of cardiometabolic health between transgender females on estradiol and age and BMI-matched control males and females. Most notably, their body composition or their percent lean and fat mass as measured by a DEXA was in between the control males and females. So they had a higher percent body fat than males and lower than females. And for lean mass, they had a lower percent lean mass than control males and higher than females. In terms of insulin sensitivity, our other outcome of interest, there was no differences in insulin sensitivity between transgender females and control females, but they were more insulin resistant or less insulin sensitive than control males. So this was one piece of a cross-sectional study. I've presented the data on transgender males or those individuals on testosterone elsewhere, and I'm also looking at a younger cohort who are just on a puberty blocker or GnRH analog but haven't yet started testosterone or estradiol. I will be publishing that data soon, hopefully in an endocrine journal. And right now as faculty, I have a longitudinal study going where I'm for right now studying transgender males before and after they start testosterone, and that data will be forthcoming as well. And really my main question and interest as a pediatric endocrinologist is, what is the impact not only of hormones on your short and long-term heart health and diabetes risk and long-term health, but also what are the impact of the puberty blockers or GnRH analogs with subsequent hormones on your health as well. That's really the understudied area, and what people don't understand is if you received a puberty blocker and then testosterone or estradiol, how does that impact your short and long-term health? And how might these changes in body composition or insulin resistance that we're seeing translate to, you know, other health outcomes later on?